Good morning. Welcome to Kehilat Shari Torah's Halacha of the Day, reviewing the laws and customs of Rosh Hashanah, the High Holidays, Yom Kippur, the 10 Days of Tshuva, Monday, August 17th. Kitzur Shulchan Aruch writes that after the Mincha service on the first day, things are a little bit different in this neighborhood. First of all, because it's Shabbat, we're not going to Tashlich, as he's talking about in this paragraph. We're not going to Tashlich on the first day, we'll do that on the second day. And we do it before Mincha, because it's a matter of time walking down and back to the river at the corner. So he says after the Mincha service, we're going to do it before. We're going to meet down there and then come back to the Shul for Mincha. We go to a river or a stream to recall the merit of the Akedah, the binding of Isaac, near sacrifice of Isaac is obviously a main theme of Rosh Hashanah, particularly the second day when it is our Torah reading. The Midrash says that when Abraham went to the Akedah with his son Yitzchak, the Satan, the no-goodnik, the negative force in the universe, transformed himself into a river to deter him, to put him off and block the way. But Avram Avinu, Alav HaShalom, walked into the river up until the water got to his neck and said, "Save me, Hashem, deliver me, for the waters have reached up to my soul." He happened to be quoting from the 69th chapter of Psalms. There's another reason for this custom. On the day of Rosh Hashanah, most of our service is focused towards proclaiming God's kingship. That's the theme of our prayers. That's why we say HaMelech HaKadosh, the Holy King, as it changed some of our prayers. That's why we sound the shofar. A number of other reasons, we are focused on God's kingship. And it was the custom in the olden days, maybe they still do it, I have never been to a coronation, it was the custom to anoint kings near a riverbank. The reason being that it's an auspicious sign that their kingdom should continue flowing, should go on without end. That from the very end of Tractate Horayot in the Talmud. It's preferable that this river should be outside the city limits. We're going to use one inside the city limits because it's a long walk to the edge of town. And it should contain fish as a reminder that we are compared to living fish who are caught in a net. We also are caught in the net of death and judgment, and as a result, we're inclined to think more of repenting if we focus on that symbolism. Another reason is to symbolize that the evil eye should have no power over us, just as it has no power over fish, and that we will continue to be fruitful and multiply just like fish. Others say the reason is that fish have no eyelids and that their eyes are always open. The purpose is to arouse compassion of the all-seeing one, Hashem, God who sees everything above us, over us, around us, in us. But if there's no river that contains fish, you can go to any river, you can go to a well, anywhere where there's water, and you say the verses Mikael Kamoicha as it's written in the Machzor after Mincha, the service of Tashlich. We also have little folders that we'll pass out if you need them. Customarily, people shake the corners of their clothes, symbolizing their resolve to cast away sins, to examine and scrutinize their ways. From now on, our garments, our practical physical garments and our spiritual garments should be white and free of all sin and transgression. And as he says here, the last couple of words, if the first day of Rosh Hashanah is on Shabbat, we go to the stream for Tashlich on the second day. Indeed, that is just what we'll do. Just as a notice for everyone, and you can spread the word about this, on the second day of Rosh Hashanah, which is the only day we're blowing the shofar, we will meet a little bit early at our normal place, a little bit before Tashlich. We'll post these times, we'll put them in the bulletin and everything. We would like to meet a little bit early for those who are not able to make it to shul for any reason, who would like to hear the shofar. We will have a shofar service outdoors at the corner of Bayview and York Mills on Sunday afternoon, second day of Rosh Hashanah, to allow for people with, of course, proper social distancing, with masks and everything, to be able to hear the shofar, which indeed is the mitzvah of the day, as we've been discussing. Okay, so we look forward to that. Look forward to continued learning about the laws of the High Holidays. Please join us again tomorrow. Have a good day.